Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today. Mycoplasma pneumoniae is a small bacterium which causes atypical pneumonia in young adults. Mycoplasma, as a genus, have a cell membrane that's packed with sterols, but they lack a proper rigid cell wall. Therefore, they don't take up dye under Gram staining, so they cannot be visualized with light microscopy. Additionally, they're highly pleomorphic bacteria, meaning that they have no fixed shape and size, and they're also osmotically unstable in the external environment. So, to survive, mycoplasmas invade host cells and live intracellularly. Now, Mycoplasma pneumoniae is a facultative anaerobe, meaning that it can live without oxygen if it has to, but it grows better in an aerobic environment. So it prefers places like lungs or respiratory airways, where there's an unlimited flow of oxygen. As a result, some people might carry this bacteria in their nose or throat, and when they sneeze or cough, these organisms get out in the form of small respiratory droplets. And when other people inhale these droplets, they might get infected, especially when they spend a lot of time together in close quarters. So Mycoplasma pneumoniae infections happen mostly in children who go to school, young adults in college, or military recruits. Following inhalation of the pathogen droplets, Mycoplasma pneumoniae attaches to an epithelial cell in the respiratory tract, using a specialized attachment organelle which has an adhesive protein complex called adhesion protein P1 at its tip. Adhesion protein P1 attaches to the host cell surface, like the respiratory epithelial cell, and holds on for dear life. This makes it way harder for the mucociliary clearance mechanisms, which normally remove any foreign pathogen out of the respiratory tract, to clear the bacteria. So Mycoplasma pneumoniae multiplies and damages the respiratory epithelial cells in the process. When they reach the lungs, this starts a local inflammatory response, and lung tissue fills with white blood cells, proteins, fluid, and even red blood cells if a nearby capillary gets damaged in the process, leading to a local cytotoxic effect. So Mycoplasma pneumoniae avoid the battlefield by sneaking inside lung cells, where they remain dormant or replicate intracellularly. As a result, individuals infected by Mycoplasma pneumoniae are often asymptomatic, or might have non-specific symptoms like fatigue, sore throat, mild fever, and dry hacking cough, all of which aren't typical of bacterial pneumonia, hence the name atypical pneumonia. Besides, the person might not feel very sick, as opposed to a person suffering from other bacterial pneumonia, where they'll be surely bedridden and suffering from more severe symptoms like dyspnea or shortness of breath, fever, chest pain, and a productive cough. This is why sometimes a case of atypical pneumonia is also referred to as walking pneumonia. Mycoplasma pneumoniae can also cause encephalitis, especially following atypical pneumonia in children. Symptoms of encephalitis include fever, changes in mental status, and neck stiffness. Diagnosing a Mycoplasma pneumoniae infection requires a chest x-ray, which reveals a patchy infiltrate that denotes severe infection. Quite the discrepancy for something called walking pneumonia. For example, here's how a normal lung looks like, and in comparison, this is how a Mycoplasma pneumoniae infected lung looks like. Besides imaging, diagnosis can also be made by getting a sputum sample and growing the organism on Eaton's agar media, which is rich in cholesterol and nucleic acids. Growth takes about 2 to 3 weeks, and Mycoplasma pneumoniae forms dome-shaped colonies, which look like fried eggs. But this takes a long time, so growing the bacteria is not commonly done. Instead, a cold agglutinin test is usually performed, which is based on the fact that certain antigens of human red blood cells and antigens of Mycoplasma cell membrane are quite similar. As a result, at 4 degrees Celsius, IgM antibodies against bacterial antigens cross-react with human red blood cell antigens and make them agglutinate, or clot. Using this basic principle, a simple bedside test can be done, where the patient's blood is taken in a tube and placed in a box of ice. If they have IgM antibodies against Mycoplasma pneumoniae, the blood clumps and the test is positive. However, these antibodies take time to develop, so a negative test doesn't necessarily rule out an infection. When encephalitis is suspected, a lumbar puncture and cerebrospinal fluid analysis are also done. Alright, now atypical pneumonia is generally self-limiting, but if it doesn't resolve on its own, antibiotics are needed. And since mycoplasmas don't have a cell wall inhibitors like beta-lactam antibiotics are inefficient. So treatment relies on antibiotics that inhibit protein biosynthesis, like tetracyclines, or macrolides like erythromycin and azithromycin. Alright, as a quick recap, Mycoplasma pneumoniae is a small bacterium that causes atypical pneumonia in young adults and military recruits. Diagnosis of atypical pneumonia can be based on a chest x-ray, which reveals patchy infiltrates, or on a positive cold agglutinin test, where clumping of red blood cells happens at 4 degrees Celsius. Mycoplasma pneumoniae can also be grown on Eaton's auger, forming fried egg colonies. But this takes 2 to 3 weeks. If the disease does not resolve on its own, tetracyclines and macrolides like erythromycin and azithromycin are used to treat the infection. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine.